Howard, long time no see. How's Pidgey doing?
He's a little down today. Misses his cousins. Been a bit of a whirlwind for both of us. Owners of my building, rezoned for commercial. We had to move into Feast to get our bearings.
I'm so sorry. New York landlords can really be heartless.
When they kicked me out of my place, they set all my birds loose. Pidgey's the only one who found me. I've been looking everywhere for the rest of them, but with my bad leg and all...
You know what? I'd get around. How about I keep an eye out for him?
You do that? Oh, thank you. If you have any luck, please give me a call.
Time to find some pigeons.
There's a pigeon! Get him! Hey, Jeff. Congrats on the ceremony today.
I'll be glad when it's over. A truck full of armed demons scares me less than public speaking. I'm calling for something else.
What's up?
Just got a tip of the... Demons are moving on the Fisk construction site in Midtown. My wife would kill me if I ditched the ceremony prep to play cops and robbers, but... I thought maybe my friendly neighborhood partner would want to know.
Understood. I'll do a swing by, let you know what I find. And hey, here's a tip on public speaking. Just picture everyone in their underwear. Wait, not Osborne. You know what? Just never mind. Hey, Howard? I think I found one of Pidgey's cousins. Dusty Gray Flex? Might have just left a stain on my suit?
Guy's a little devil, but he's a chopper. Give him a pat on the head and point him towards me. He'll find his way.
No problem. I'll do the same for any others I find.
Taking you home, buddy.
Another message from Doc.
Peter, I don't want to jinx us, but the lead I'm following might not only get the project back on its feet, but also expand it in ways we never could have imagined. Everything happens for a reason, even Norman pulling our plug.
Really hope this works out. Doc's work is too important to go unfinished. Oh no, there it goes! It is my responsibility to catch that pigeon. I can't do this. Gotcha.
Show us your face already!
Pigeon target acquired.
Don't fly away, please! Taking you home, buddy.
Join our brothers and sisters.
Happy to help. these little guys pretty well, huh?
Getting there. Sandra always knew him best, of course.
Sandra?
Oh, my wife.
Well, tell Sandra she's got some fine birds.
Oh, yeah. Shoot me a Spider-Man. Thanks again. And please, keep an eye out.
I hope nobody sees me doing this. One of Howard's pigeons. Come on. This is a fast one. One of Howard's pigeons. Oh no, there it goes. This pigeon knows the city better than I do. Okay. Pigeon alert! And the chase is on. Okay! Sandra happy to see them back?
Well, actually, she's not with us anymore. Cancer, you know.
Howard, I'm so sorry.
Oh, it's okay. Life's for living, not moping. First thing she told me after the diagnosis. Gotta remind myself of that every now and again. Keep looking, will you? Finding the rest of these birds would really mean a lot. Thanks, Spider-Man.
Pigeons eat spiders.
Okay.
It's all over the news. Another battle between Spider-Man and these demon masked gunmen threatening the lives of New Yorkers. I understand our next caller lives in the area. You're on with J. Jonah Jameson.
Yeah, the thing is, it all happened in the shipyard that's been closed for years. There weren't any innocent people in danger.
Oh, is that your expert opinion? Well, let me tell you what I've learned from sources I developed in my award-winning journalism career. That shipyard was a front for Wilson Fisk. He's been using it to smuggle guns, grenades, military-grade ordnance.
Oh, that explains a lot.
Ah, the truth bomb strikes. But wait, here's a 50-megaton payload of fact. While Spider-Man tried to grab the glory for himself, chasing one truck, another vehicle got away with an arsenal of deadly, illegal weapons. Fisk, for all his faults, would never have let them be used in these demons? Either they're some kind of fanatical cult, or they just don't care. Anybody feel like they're in danger now?
One of Howard's pigeons.
Don't fly away, please!
Hey, slow down! Man, I wish I spoke pigeon. Pigeon. Ah, gotta get him. Sweat, Howard. These birds are lucky to have you.
I try. Sandra was always better with them. They're her birds, really.
Well, now that she's gone, they're yours.
Feels like a part of her lives on that way, you know?
I definitely know. You're a good man, Howard.
Anytime you want to stop by and see the family, feel free.